所有在场的朋友们，你们大家好吗？哦，所有广州的朋友们，你们好！以及所有正在收看我们直播的朋友们，收看我们 QQ 音乐、酷狗音乐以及酷我音乐的所有直播的朋友们，大家好！欢迎大家能够来到我们Taylor Swift Lover， 中国粉丝见面会，我是今天的主持人陈准飞杨迪。哇哦哇哦哇哦！啊，每个人都特别特别兴奋，对不对？现在已经等待不及了。哎呦，因为我知道今天晚上很多的朋友们都是我们的 TME 非常重要的支持者，也是我们 Taylor Swift。的一个非常非常棒的一些粉丝们才会来到现场，你们才会有机会可以抽中这样子的一个机会来到我们现场，跟我们 Taylor Swift 有一个近距离的一个接触。那当然呢，这一次我们要非常感谢到的就是我们所有腾讯音乐娱乐集团的邀请以及我们的环球唱片的邀请，所以我们 Taylor Swift 才会来到我们现场。我们谢谢我们的 TME 好不好？谢谢我们的环球唱片好不好？给他们最热烈的掌声！我刚才一开始的时候就有讲了，我们位置上面都有我们的荧光棒，赶快拿起你的荧光棒出来，让我们的 Taylor 感受到你们的 love。但是我觉得今天在现场所有的朋友们，你们应该都是很兴奋的，想要叫出他的名字。把他给喊出来，对不对？让我们大声的把他给喊出来，好不好 ？Taylor Taylor 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 Taylor。
Amazing. Thank you.
Oh, just a little heart. This is your love for me.
You got one too. Oh. Yeah. There.
Oh, thank you, thank
you. All right. Guys, I heard how loudly you were just singing the song Lover, and I'm so thankful. That was amazing.
Yes, because we have like people sitting right here from Guangzhou.Of course, we have a lot of fans that is all the way watching the live stream.
Yes, thank you to everyone who's watching the live stream. That's amazing.
On the QQ Music, on Google Music, and Kuwa Music. Thank you all for watching tonight. And of course, because we have Taylor here. Do you feel the love?
I do. This is insane. This is amazing. Really? I love you guys so much.
Because I don't think you...但是我觉得 Taylor 还没有感受到我们的爱 because I don't think you feel the love yet.
Oh, okay.
I don't think you feel the love yet.
Alright.
Because we have more, 我们应该还有更多的爱给 Taylor, 对不对? Right? Show our love! Those exchanges? Yes! Because we can actually feel the love from you.
Well, it's so amazing to get an opportunity to come and say to you, thank you so much for all of the support with my album, Lover. You have been so incredibly supportive and just wonderful to me for so many years. And so I just wanted to say thank you from the bottom of my heart. I really appreciate you.
这是我们朋友说，在过去这么多的一些时间之内，其实呢，大家都已经感受到你们大家所有人的爱，因为其实在过去这段时间之内，大家一直在支持我们的 Taylor。而且大家都知道，因为这一张专辑 Lover 里面有非常多的浪漫的感觉。There's a lot of romantic feel in this new album Lover. 你们有没有感觉到这个感觉呢？ Yes. 那当然在今天我们就要来好好问一下我们的 Taylor 有关于这张专辑。Because the Lover is so romantic, so sweet.And so beautiful. You see the butterfly, you see everything. How did you come up with the concept with the new album?
It just felt like a natural progression from my last album, which was called Reputation. Thanks. So that album was very dark by design. It was very much about kind of exploring angst and exploring all the things that go with...going through a darker time in your life, but then afterward, it just felt like a natural thing to go into a lighter part of life because that's the way that my life was going. And my albums always reflect what's really happening in my life. So I just tried to follow what instinct told me to do, and intuition told me that we should make a really, really romantic, free, lovely, happy album.
And we love that! 其实我刚刚问一下 Taylor， 就是他这一次 Lover 这样子一张专辑，他是从哪边得到这样子的灵感？他说手上一张专辑我们的 Reputation 的时候是比较黑暗一点，那其实他那时候可能给人家感觉，因为他是设计这样子黑暗的感觉，但是很自然呢，很自然的时间，他现在来到了一个非常充满了爱的感觉，所以才会有那么多 colorful， 然后那么多很多的一些漂漂亮亮的东西，就像他今天晚上穿的一样。穿得漂不漂亮？
So pretty. I'm going to say that you're so pretty. Yes.
Thank you.
Because I know that before you choose Lover as the title track, because there was a daylight, and then you thought that you were going to use daylight before the Lover came
up. Yes, exactly. Yes. That was an idea that I was toying around with because the song Daylight to me.Was I think one of the first songs that I wrote that made me realize what I wanted to make. But then when I wrote the song Lover, I just thought, this is the title. Like, this is such a universal, fun, happy title that can mean so many things. And there are so many things that I'm writing about on this album. And so I figured a name like Lover was the most evocative title that I could pick. So I'm glad you guys like it, honestly.
Yeah. 之前呢，本来听了他是想要选 Daylight 这首歌来做他们的专辑的这张专辑。哎，你知道你每次这样子会，我会吓到人，你知道吗？就吓你。本来是要选 Daylight 这首歌来做他的专辑的名称，但是当 Lover 这首歌出来了以后，他就觉得 Lover 这首歌更加的符合他现在的心态。所以呢，他就决定用 Lover 这首歌来作为他的专辑的名称。
But there's one more question I want to ask you.This question is because I think it's for all of the fans because we all know that you love planting Easter eggs.
I do. Yes, I definitely do that.
Yes, yes. Why do you like it so much?
I think when I was a little kid, I used to love books where you'd have to find something really small, like I Spy books or Where's Waldo or something like that. I loved having to figure something out. And I think it's fun when people who are like me and like to figure things out, they can go as far into it as they want.
Yes.
But if you don't like to figure out clues, then you can just watch the music video and you'll never notice them.
Oh.
So.
And we love the clues. The five holes, the palm trees.
其实我刚才就问他说，为什么那么喜欢在很多的音乐录影带、很多很多的照片里面摆下很多不一样的一些秘密啊，或者是让大家去 discover 的一些东西？他说，其实他就是小时候就很喜欢在家里面，然后看很多的这些图片画有没有，然后在里面可以找到一些很多不一样的一些线索，所以他就觉得说，希望能够透过这些 MV 的部分，让大家能够有一些 interaction 的感觉。
Because we know that you love interacting with all of your fans, right?
你都知道他也很喜欢跟我们所有的粉丝朋友们有互动。
So that's why Kuwo Music actually have five fans that's going to ask you questions.
Amazing.
From their perspective.
Great.
Great. 所以透过我们的酷我音乐呢，其实会找到了我们五位粉丝朋友们，他们可以来问我们的 Taylor 一些问题。我们一起来听一下好不好？ Let's have a look.
Great.
All 18 sounds in Lover, which sound took up most of time for you to come up with the melody?
That's a great question. Thank you so much for sending in that question, and thank you, Kuo Music, for arranging for people to ask questions. It's all very great. That's a good question. I think that the song Daylight was the one that took me the longest.To write because I had several different verse melodies、
okay.
for it, and I couldn't figure out which one was the best one. And it took me a while because I had written the chorus and I'd written the bridge, but I had like three different ways I could sing the melody of the verse, and I kept changing my mind. So most of the songs on this album I wrote very quickly, and they happened so fast. I wrote a lot of the songs on this album alone.Or predominantly alone, and it just was really, really an easy album to write. So that was one of the only times where I was just really like, what do I do here?、Mm. And then I eventually figured it out.、
Mm.
So, great question.
Great question. 非常好的一个问题。刚才这个问题是说，在这张专辑里面18首歌曲里面，哪一首歌曲对他来讲的话，他在创作音乐上面会比较困难一些？他说其实是 Daylight 这首歌，因为其他的歌曲呢，他其实在创作上面都速度非常非常快，但是 Daylight 这首歌曲呢，他其实反复的思索了非常多次，而且他有很多不一样的一些唱法，所以呢，他觉得 Daylight 这首歌是对他来讲会比较那时候在创作上面的时候可能碰到了一些问题。Wow, Daylight, I never really thought of that.
Yeah, or there's a song that I had wanted to write for years and years and years called The Man.
Yeah.
But I...
Thank you.
That was really nice. Thank you so much.
Okay, okay. All right, 我们现在来看一下我们下一个问题。Let's have a look at the second question.
Yes.
Yes.
Hi Taylor, my name is Phoebe and I'm a big fan of you. What is your favorite album from all of your albums? Mine is Red. And after all, I just want to say that Chinese fans love you and we appreciate your music really, really much.
Aww!
Phoebe, thank you!
Thank you! That was great. And I love that she loves the album Red. That is so, so great. Thank you.
因为 Phoebe 很喜欢 Red 这张专辑。
I think that my favorite album that I've made, to be very honest, is Lover, because it's got the most amount of songs. It was such an experience where I felt so free to make whatever I wanted to make. It's an album that I personally own. It'll be in my life and in my family forever. That's really important to me. And it's a very eclectic album, so I love that about it. I love that it's not just pop, it's not just acoustic. It's got singer-songwriter elements. Mm-hmm. It's got songs that you can dance to. So I felt really good about putting out an album that has that much...kind of that many different sides to it.
Diversity.
Yeah, it's as complex as love is.
Yes,、yeah. yes, I love the way that you put it.
Oh, thanks. Hey.
刚才 Phoebe 的问题是说哪一张专辑是他个人最喜欢的，他说他就是最喜欢这张专辑 Lover. 你们应该也是吧？Lover 这张专辑呢，因为里面除了有18首歌，而且每一首歌的它的风格都不太一样，所以整体的非常多元，而且他自己以及他全家还有他所有身边的朋友都非常喜欢这张专辑 Lover 18首歌。 Alright, let's have a look at the second question, the third question. 我们来看一下下一个问题。
Hey Taylor, I remember you used three words to describe yourself on Ellen's show, which were curious, romantic, and cat lover. And I wonder if you could name three words to describe your new album Lover, which we love so much, and we hope you have fun in China and love you so much.
That was such a sweet thing. That was such a really sweet question and such a nice thing for her to say.Thank you so much for sending in that question. I think that if I had to pick three words to describe the album Lover. They would be free.
Three?
Free.
Oh, free. Okay, free.
Like
free,
it's free. It just feels free. Like okay. It feels like freedom.
非常自由，这是一个他形容他专辑的其中一个字。
Because I felt free to write whatever I wanted to write. I felt like I was in a very free place in my life. I feel like I've grown up enough to feel free in taking up space in the world. Mm-hmm. And so I think with that growing up process, I felt a new sense of freedom in my own life. The second word I would choose is eclectic.
Collected.
Eclectic, because it's very... it's very quirky. There are different parts of the album that are a little bit weirder in good ways, I think, than things that I've made before. And I really like getting to take chances and challenge myself. And the fans are the reason why I get to make music that is always kind of a little bit different than what I've made before.
Yes. 他说其实这张专辑里面他受到很多大家的启发，所以他创作了很多不一样的音乐。
So, the third word that I would say would be passionate, because...you know, I think that love, whether you're on the good side of love or the bad side of love, whether you're falling for someone or missing someone, that all involves a lot of passion. And so, you know, I'm very passionate about songwriting, and the process of writing this album was the most fun I've ever had as a creator. So those are my three words, and I am so appreciative for the question. It was a really good question, and that's my answer for it.
All right, very good. Good answer. 他的第三个回答呢，就是他如果第三个形容词的话，他其实是说是非常非常的热情，因为其实在这张专辑里面，不管他可以呈现出来爱情的各个不一样方方面面，都是感受到你一定要有热情才有办法爱。All right, let's have a look at the fourth question.
Okay.
All right.看一下第四题。
Hi, Taylor, it's Arlene. In the past few years, we've seen your music style change from country to pop, which has been an incredible journey, and in your newest album, Lover, we found it even more diversified, like False God or It's Nice to Have a Friend, for example. So, if you're gonna work on some of these different styles in the future according to people's reaction, or can we suppose it's a sign of your new direction?
Oh, is it going to be a sign of a new direction?
That's a great question. You know, the one of the most amazing things about my relationship with you guys is that you have made it very clear to me that as long as the lyrics touch your heart, as long as the lyrics apply to your life, you are very, you're wonderful at letting me experiment musically. And I am so grateful for that. So...I'd say that it was, hi. Wow.
Okay, 我先跟大家先翻译一部分哈，因为我怕我待会儿忘掉I just don't want to forget some of the things that you said. Okay. 所以他刚刚说呢，其实这张专辑最主要的原因是因为所有东西都是跟你们粉丝是有非常大的一些关系，因为粉丝你给我们有很多的一些感受，就是因为你们的感受，所以才可以让我在创作上面有很多不一样的一些尝试。 Okay, there you go.
Thank you. That was great.
Did you understand any of it?
All of it. What was I saying? Oh, I was saying the fact that when I was putting out music, I think it was probably on my second or third, maybe fourth album, that I started to realize that the fans are the ones who like it when I experiment and challenge myself musically, that you don't want me to just make the same thing over and over again. So that was what gave me sort of the freedom to really play around with the music that I make, and that's what's made it such an enriching experience for me as an artist, and I'm so grateful to you for that. So thank you for that.
Okay, so Taylor 他说他其实在第二张或者第三张专辑的时候，他那时就有感觉到，其实这所有的专辑里面的每一首歌都是跟你们粉丝是非常非常有关系的。所以呢，从那时候开始，他就决定一定要每一次的一个风格都是因为你们的关系，我们就会有所挑战。他也给他许多不一样的一些挑战。All right, so that's the fourth question. Let's have a look at the fifth.
Let's see the fifth question.
The final question.
Hi, Taylor. This is Aiken. When I was 13, I listened to your first song, Breeze, and that was the moment I decided to learn English. Now I am 24. I majored in simultaneous interpreting. Thank you for encouragement and enlightenment. I want to ask you a question. What do you want to say to the kids and the teenagers in their formative years?
青少年朋友们会有什么东西想要说的？因为这一位其实对是 Taylor 给他有一个很大的一些影响。
That just made me so like that made me so proud and happy and just excited and that's amazing. I'm so honored that my song Breathe made you want to learn how to speak English. That's so wonderful and inspiring. Just so cool.
因为这一位呢，他其实他在会学英文的原因，就是因为 Taylor 的关系。
It's a great question. The question of, you know, what advice would I give teenagers? I think that one thing that I always tend to do when I stress myself out the most is I look too far forward in advance and I try to predict what will happen in the future. So I'll go 10 years in advance.And I'll be like, what am I going to do in 10 years? Where am I going to live? What's my life going to be like? What album what am I going to make in 10 years? What am I going to do? How am I going to, you know, and then I'll completely freak out.
Yes.
Because I think one thing I would say to teenagers or anyone really is that that's not fair to do to yourself. Like, try as hard as you can to stay present because in the present moment, what you're dealing with, you can handle. You know, just don't be...too hard on yourself about how does my decision today affect 5 years from now. And we're geared towards striving for success, and
yes.
that is good. But, you know, there's a difference between being excited by a challenge and becoming completely absorbed in anxiety that is just basically fear you're borrowing from the future.
Yes.
So I know this is a really long answer. I'm so sorry.
No, it's okay. I think I have a really good memory.
I'm so sorry. But I think the basis of what I'm trying to say is try to stay present. Try to be where you are. Don't miss it. Where you are is probably pretty special, and it's only going to happen the one time.
So living in the moment, 活在当下，这就是我们的 Taylor 特别特别想要跟我们所有的朋友们一起来分享的，因为其实这是哇，OK， 所以就是想要跟大家讲说，因为他之前也是非常非常的哇，好，我知道大家都很兴奋，但是我们接下来继续多了解一下我们的 Taylor 在专辑成长，好不好？好不好？All right, let's talk about the album, because you talk about how you wrote most of the songs solo-ly in this album.
Yeah, I wrote...
Isn't that exciting?
It is fun to write songs alone, and I do love to collaborate. Like, I've gotten to write with such amazing writers. You know, when I started writing to when I moved to Nashville, co-writing and collaborating is such an amazing part of making music, and I really do love to have...someone that I can bounce ideas off of because I tend to come up with so many ideas that it's really about editing which ones are good.
Yes.
And also getting, so I love to collaborate with people, but sometimes, you know, when I'll be prepping an idea to bring into a collaborator, sometimes the idea...I won't be able to stop myself from finishing it. And that's what happened on some of the songs from Lover, where I would just be sitting at the piano and I'd try to stop myself after writing the first chorus, and then I'd just end up writing the second verse and then the bridge, and then the song's done.
Yeah, yeah.
So, that's what happened.
But this one is very different, though. This one is that you go to solo-ly most of the music, right?
The, you know, I've always, I love, writing is my favorite process.
Yes.
So, yeah, writing songs alone is, I mean, it's, you're just alone, so
yeah.
It's not as fun as when you're, like, sitting there with someone else and you're bouncing ideas off. But you do get this quiet sense of pride of, like, this was a very pure, singular experience of just something that I was going through, and it wasn't about which is the best idea. It was
yes.
about this is just something I needed to convey in that moment.
All right. So
I
just asked...
The longest answer. I'm so sorry I keep doing this to you. I need to be more
concise. Because I'm pretty sure FBAR's English is really, really good.
Yes, you guys are awesome.
All right. But I think I still need to translate a little bit.
叫我不要翻译啊。They were like, you don't need to translate. You don't need to translate. OK. 所以呢，其实我刚才在讲说有关于他这一次的这张专辑，大部分的一些歌曲都是他自己写的。他说他之前很喜欢跟很多的一些朋友们一起写歌，因为他觉得在一个过程当中非常的有趣。但是他这一次呢，其实在自我写作的一个过程当中，他就觉得说是一个完全不一样的一个体验。But you were talking about composing. You were talking about composing. Okay.
You guys are amazing. I love you. You're amazing.
我在这边再问一个问题哈 ，Because we know that you love composing, you love making music. Well, everybody here loves singing karaoke as well. So, between making music and singing, what is your favorite? what is easier for you?
I love both, but for me, writing is easier. It's just easier than singing because I can write if I have a cold. I can write if I'm sick.I can write if I, you know, but if I'm going on stage to sing, I have to not be sick. I、yes. have to not have talked too much and blown my voice out. So it's easier for me to write because the conditions can be anything.
Yes.
My health can be whatever. And like, but, you know, I love both. And you guys make it so much fun because you're such amazing crowds and you're so loving and supportive.
他说在创作还有唱歌里面呢，他其实非常非常喜欢，两个都非常喜欢，但是呢可能创作对他来讲会比较简单一点，因为他不管身体是什么样子的状况或是在什么样子的空间里面，他都可以来进行创作，所以呢创作对他来讲会比较简单。 But you know what? Everyone here loves singing karaoke in China and they all sing Paris Whistler.我们接下来因为有酷狗的粉丝，他们呢其实有五位透过酷狗音乐的平台，然后呢透过镜头也要唱歌给我们的 Taylor Swift， 我们来听一下好不好。 There are five fans that is collected by Kugo and they are going to sing some of the songs from the album Lover.
Amazing.
And they submitted the video. Let's have a look.
Yes.
Let's go.
Can I go? Can you always be this?
incredible. I want to say a huge thank you to anyone who sent in one of those videos. Everyone was so talented.
They are.
They're so talented. That was incredible. Wow. And bonus points for the cat. Obviously.
他说给那个长毛的那个小女生是多得分的. Yeah.
That was so beautiful. Every single one of them was so beautiful. I really appreciate it. I take it as such an honor when people choose to do a cover song of a song that I've written, because I know how important that choice is.
Yes.
When you're going to sing a song and learn it and put it on the internet. So just, that is so awesome. And anybody who's ever covered a song of mine, like, thank you.
Oh.
That's great. I love it.
他说他非常非常的感动，因为每个人花了很多的力气来唱这些歌曲. But I know that because this platform, Kugo Music, gather all five singers.
Yes, thank you, Kugo Music. That is so amazing. And thank you for finding them. Thank you for putting them on the TV.
Yes.
That was amazing. I loved it.
Very, very nice. Huh?
Yeah, it was so great.
Yeah. 其实我们在现场真的有很多我们的Taylor的粉丝朋友们。 We have like all of the fans from all around China. Let's talk about cats. What the hell is this? Oh, that's the new one.
Oh, it's Benjamin.
Oh, Benjamin.
That's Meredith.
It's Meredith.
And then there's...
And there's like... Olivia.
There's Benjamin again, and there's Olivia.
Olivia's the photogenic one.
She's... Olivia likes to really relax very aggressively. There's Olivia again. Meredith. That's the ladies. That's both girls.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, because I know that the Benjamin Button is the newest cat, newest to the family.
He's the newest cat. He's also now the biggest by about double the size. Yeah.
How big is he right now?
He's like...
So puffy.
He's really puffy, but he's just a very like fast-growing cat.
What did you feed him?
We feed him the same amount as the other cats. It's
really?
Just, he just keeps growing, and he's a good boy. He's a really, really, he's like a really friendly cat. Like, he follows me around the house. Like, I'm never anywhere in the house that Benjamin isn't.
Oh, really?
He's always next to me, or like in my lap. He's a good boy.
We'll be like, follow me around.
Yeah, just
follow me around. 那我们刚才在讲说他现在有三只猫，最新的一只猫是 Benjamin，我相信很多的朋友你们都知道，对不对？好，他说 Benjamin现在变得非常非常大，虽然说他现在是最新的一只猫，但是他非常非常大。然后呢，他就是在房间里面到处就跟他到处都是，对。所以呢，其实我们的 Benjamin 也是非常非常可爱的。那当然说我们在这边就要问一下，because we know that the Benjamin is the newest one. Is it okay, like, to fit into the family when Olivia and Meredith are
it's
there?
It's great now. It wasn't for a while, obviously. It was very dramatic. Anytime a new cat is introduced into the house, Meredith is always just like, why? Why would you need this? Why would you do this?
How does she say why? She would be like...
She says it like this. Stares at me and doesn't blink and just judges me all day.
Very judgmental.
But now she's like happy. She's happy now that she has siblings to play with.
Good, because
they're so fun. You know, they chase each other around.
Yes.
Cat games.
Yes.
You know how it is.
Wow. 所以我觉得我们的 Benjamin 刚到家里面的时候 Meredith 可能对他有点敌意，但现在他们就变成一个很快乐的一个大家庭. But that, we are not only talking about cats. In the house, we are also talking about the cats,
the musical movie.
Oh, yes. Absolutely.
Yes, let's talk about that, Kat.
It was so much fun. Honestly, like, getting to be a part of this was one of the most hilarious, fun, exciting experiences, because the show is, like, the movie is all live singing and dancing, so we'd be live singing and dancing over and over and over again, and there was so many rehearsals, and everybody was so committed, and we were also really committed to the fact that, like, Cats the musical is just, like, crazy and makes very little sense, just like Cats,
yeah.
The creatures. Yeah. So the fact that that was, like, something that the film is committing to feels like a real true homage to the actual musical.
Yes.
Also, it just was, like, it was so great because I had just gotten off of a stadium tour, and so I had been singing and dancing and really performing a lot, and so I went right into making a movie where there was a lot of live singing and dancing. It was all live singing and dancing, actually. And so I had a really great time, and I got to write an original song for the musical Cats with Andrew Lloyd Webber.
Ooh, legendary!
It was so much fun, like, just how it all came about. Like, I still can't believe that it happened, and he's so much fun and nice and great, and I love the song, and you'll get to hear it soon. It comes out soon, I think. But I'm excited.
在我们的音乐剧电影 Cats 里面呢，其实我们到时候 Taylor Swift 会在里面扮演一个角色，他也跟里面的作曲家，也就是 Andrew Lloyd Webber 呢，他们也合作了一首歌曲。那这首歌曲呢，之后也会跟大家见面。那当然，在这部电影里面，我们的 Taylor 也会在里面有一个非常好的一个表演，大家都会非常期待。Are you guys looking forward to it? All right, everybody's looking forward to it. So we talk about the Cats, we talk about the movie, and we also talk about the music and all that. Let's talk about fashion.
Okay. Because let's talk about fashion. This is a great outfit. Do a walk. Walk. It's great.
But no, because we know that Taylor's fashion is everybody's, like, following your trend.
What?
Everybody say,
I don't know.
Let's have a look what Taylor is wearing today.
That's really flattering. Oh.
Look at that.
Oh, like, really, let's have a look. Okay, cool. Oh, it's my Instagram pictures.
And they are all, like, the album Lover, very diversified.
Yeah, it's a lot of pictures of outfits. I mean, that's one of the things that's fun about this, is you get to put on clothes and you get to wear them.
Yeah, get to wear them.
It's part of it that's really fun. I don't think I'm, like, a fashion influencer.
No?
No. I think other people are way better at that, but you do have to, you know, put on clothes to make music, so...
他说他并不觉得他自己是一个很会穿衣服的人，但是呢，他觉得他的衣服其实就是像刚刚看到一样 Instagram 上面的一些很多一些很漂亮。Do you have the favorite style that you have?
Well, I go through a cycle in the year usually, except for Reputation, where I only wore dark colors, but that was a different thing. I usually in the fall I start to wear, like, maroon, navy blue, hunter green, mustard yellow. Those are the colors that I like to wear in, like, the fall. And then in the winter, I like to wear, like, black turtlenecks a lot. And then in the spring, I start to really want to wear, like, pastels again. And in the summer, I want to wear flowy dresses. That's a very, like, it's been that way for a couple years.
Yeah.
So I'm pretty predictable, actually.
So it all depends on the season and on the mood of the day.
Yeah, and there are a couple of things that are just that I always want to wear, like glitter.
Glitter.
So
beautiful.
It's really fun getting to play dress up and do this. You know, I've been into suits lately. That's a good suit.
You like this?
Situation. I love it.
Yeah, I'm going to lunch and put it on later.
You're
on today.
Very fashionable. It's great.
是的，其实我们 Taylor 他说呢，他在每一个季节的时候都会穿不一样的一些衣服，但是都是看季节，然后也是看他自己当时的一些心情而定。但是整体上面看起来的话，他其实是很好预期说他会穿什么样子的衣服的。So since even though you don't think you are such, you don't think that you are a style or fashion icon, but a lot of people actually follow what you wear.
That's really nice. I feel like so many other people are better at wearing like what's on trend.
Yes.
That's really very, that's a nice compliment. Thank
so you. So the platform of QQ Music, 我们今天在 QQ 音乐上面呢有五位粉丝。We have five fans from the QQ Music that is right here.Dressing up like Taylor Swift.
Yes! Oh, wow. Amazing. Well, they'll wear it better than me. This is going to be amazing.
Oh, we will never know.
They will.
Oh, okay. But they are going to do a catwalk. 他们待会会出来走一下秀。
This is amazing. They're doing a catwalk. Where are they catwalking?
Okay, before they start doing the catwalk, do you want to show them, like, how do you usually...If they want to walk like Taylor Swift.
Oh, one foot in front of the other.
One just foot.
Try not to fall down.
Try not to fall down.
Yeah. You're not always going to not fall down, but try.
Okay.
Because we're both pretty tall. So the taller you are, the more you can fall.
The more unbalanced you can be.
And the further you have to go if you fall.
So it's just like,
No, it's like, when you walk like this...You're just...
I know a lot of supermodels that would be like, walking like this.
Yeah, but that's cool. That looked cool.
Not on me, though.
You looked
not
super cool doing that. I don't know. I just like... I actually have had to work on, because I naturally go like this. So I have to work on getting my toes straight.
Oh.
It's been a huge like note with like when I've learned choreography and stuff. Choreographers are always like, stop it. Like, toes straight.
What do you mean toes straight?
Like my toes point in naturally.
Oh, okay, okay. So,
so
you have
not,
to pick a toe straight.
It's not correct.
Okay, okay.
So,
House.
I don't, this wasn't the answer you were looking for. It's
no, we're just happy to listen to your voice. 所以呢，在今天呢，我们有五位粉丝，待会儿会上场给他们做一个 fashion show。我们到时候一定要给他们最热情的掌声还有尖叫声，好不好？ All right, let's move.
Amazing. To
this part of the stage. Hi, everyone there. Okay. So, ladies and gentlemen, 所有在场的先生们、女士们 this is QQ Music Fashion Show.
Stressing and obsessing about somebody else is no fun. And snakes and stones never broke my bones. Oh, you need to calm down. You're being too loud. And I'm just like, oh, you need to just stop. But can you just not?
QQ 音乐带给我们五位粉丝哦、oh, she's crying 开始激动到不行
哦、oh. So amazing The choreography too
The choreography
So good
来我们每个人排排站站好好不好 OK So Taylor
I want to know so many things.
So many things from them,
right? I have so many questions.
Yeah, like, look at them.
I want to know about, like, did you make your costume? Did you have your costume made?
Yes, right?
Did you get it somewhere?
Taobao.
She actually bought it online.
Oh, amazing. Yeah. That's a really good one for buying that online.
You know Ali.
Alibaba. Like yesterday, you joined the show.
The wig looks so good on you, too. This is from when I was, like, 18 or 19. Oh, you guys know better than I do. That's amazing. They're like, it's Speak Now. All right, so this is a Halloween costume that I wore.
Yes, I made this, 1989.
You made it?
Yeah, I made it with my mom.
Oh! Yes! Tell your mom I said hi, and that you guys did an amazing job. That was incredible.
All right, how about you? You were like sassy.
The walk. It was amazing, the walk.
This outfit is from Red Sura, and it was customized.
You got custom made. That is so good. Thank you.
Very nice.
It was the confidence level. Like, that's who you need to be asking about how to do a runway walk. That is the expert.
He said you walk very well. Because he has like long legs.
It was like the cross. It was really great.
Wow, Tete 讲你很会走哦。All right, how about you? What's your name? Okay, Joey.
I loved how you took off the sunglasses too. It was very,
just
very
like,
confident.
Yeah, the opening of the 1989 World Tour, I love it so much.
Thank you so much.
And I love you so much.
I love you too. I love you all. This is awesome.
他每一位都哭了。来，剩下你了 ，Alice。
Hi, I'm Alice. Taylor, I covered your 22 live show in the Billboard Music Award. Yes.
Amazing. Yes.
And it's created by my team from SCBC. So Taylor, we want to say welcome to China. We all love you so much.
Thank you so much. Everyone is so amazing, and the fact that you put so much work into the costumes. And the costumes on stage are not the only costumes I have seen in this audience. I've seen a lot of people dressing up. Thank you to everyone who dressed up, the mid signs.
Oh, wow. So there are like 6 tillers on the stage.
Yes, confirmed.
6 tillers. It would be nice to actually 6 tillers together. It's such a rare opportunity, right?
Yeah. Oh, yes, I would love that. I was like, how are we going to... I can't tell if it's a joke. But it's actually, we're going to get a picture. Do you want to get a picture? Amazing.
把最热烈的掌声送给我们五位粉丝们，好不好 ？Thank you. Thank you. 我们谢谢粉丝们，谢谢你们。
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. This is your phone, right?
Oh, I have all of the footage.
Thank you.
Wow. So it's actually.
It's actually very, very nice to have QQ Music to arrange all of this for us, right?
Yeah, it was amazing that QQ Music has done this. Don't you guys think that this is an amazing thing that they did, putting this together for us?
我们谢谢 QQ 音乐。
Yes, thank you QQ Music and Kuo and Kugo as well. That was, it's been so amazing getting to do this, and I'm so happy and grateful to get to be here.
Wow, so it was such a beautiful night, and we are here with Taylor Swift. But you know what? You are so. Everybody loves you so much, right? You love Chinese. I'll teach you. Love.
Teach me backstage.
Okay. All right. So, right now, we are going to have a look at how Lover has done such an amazing, amazing achievement on the TME. So because they have achieved like double diamonds on the QQ Music.
Oh, that's great.
And triple platinum.
Wow.
And Kugo and Kuo Music. Mm-hmm. So this amazing, amazing achievement here. So how do you feel?
I feel amazing because the fans are so supportive and so incredible. And just the fact that you've been so loud and loving tonight and warm and welcoming. It's, I appreciate it so much. QQ Music, Kuo and Kugo, getting us all together is so amazing. And I just, you know, the fact that the album has done so well here is only because of you, and I am just so grateful. So thank you so much.
Taylor 特别感谢我们 QQ 音乐，还有酷狗音乐，还有我们的酷我音乐，因为也就是你们所有的粉丝朋友们，才可以让我们的 Taylor 这一张全新的专辑《Lover》能够获得到那么大的一个回响。See, I'm really so excited. I'm really so excited. And then, because we know that everybody wants to show your love to Taylor Swift, right?每个人都想要献给我们 Taylor 你们最大最大的爱心，对不对？ All right, 我们先来看一下，到底如果是我们的视频拍到你的话，你用你最创意的方式来展现你的爱心，好不好？ So, look at the screen. Yeah, our screen. The way of love to you. Very nice.
It's so nice. It's just so wonderful. And, you know, to be so far away from where I'm from and to feel so welcomed is beyond, beyond my wildest dreams for what I thought would ever happen with my music. And the fact that you have been so, so wonderful to me, I will never, ever stop saying thank you.
他说从他来自那么远的一个地方，但是能够来到我们这样子一个东方古国，而且受到那么大家的欢迎，真的是非常非常感谢在场的所有的朋友们。 So, there were 5 fans on the stage and they get a chance to take a picture with you. How about
Let's do it.
Great.我们大家一起来拍一个大合照，好不好？
Photographers.
前面的朋友们站起来吧！哎，前面的朋友小心一点。OK， 前面的朋友小心一点啊！小心！上面的朋友。
点，来，一起来拍掌。
Make some noise for this amazing job that was done. He's so incredible.
谢谢所有的粉丝朋友们。当然，除了我之外，我们再一次谢谢 Taylor， 好不好？因为今天我们的时间过得非常非常的快。Oh, we have like the Taylor marry me lovers. Tell us who I love you. We have all of the fans up there.Time flew. 来，我们请前面的所有的粉丝朋友们，我们可以先坐下来，好不好？好不好 ？Let's go back to your seat. Go back to your seat and be safe. 大家都要安全，好不好？大家坐下来。好好好，乖乖乖乖乖，大家都坐下来。可以，当然大家坐下来，坐下来，乖乖乖乖，好不好？我们前面的粉丝朋友们。Before you go, do you want to say anything to all of the fans tonight?
I think all I want to say is that I love you so much and I'm so appreciative to have you in my life. The fact that you would want to come and you would want to be here tonight and the fact that you would make signs and memorize lyrics and sing them and...care about the music that I make means so much to me and I hope that you know that. Like, I hope you know how much it means to me that you care about me and my music. I love you so much. Thank you so much for everything. And I hope I get to see you again really soon. And I love you.
当然今天我们要特别谢谢我们的 TME, because of the TME and because of the QQ music, because of the Google music and Google music.Thank you so much. 我们再一次把最热烈的掌声送给我们的 Taylor Swift.感谢到的是我们的腾讯音乐娱乐以及我们的环球唱片还有我们的 QQ 音乐酷狗音乐以及我们的酷我音乐邀请我们 Taylor 来到中国那当然呢我们今天的所有直播在这边告一个段落了再一次谢谢大家我们下次见拜拜